Hi, this is Don Martelli, Vice President and Director of Digital Communications in the Boston office. Been with MSNL for about 2 years now, 2.5 years. I am responsible for developing strategies and implementing programs on behalf of all of our clients across all the the buckets we have here in Boston, whether it be healthcare, public affairs, and consumer. And so what I usually do is work with the team directors to develop what sort of platforms or strategies we are going to implement on behalf of these programs.
And what does it mean to you, Don, to be a digital activist, and how are you working on behalf of your clients on a day-to-day basis?
I'm through and through a hardcore tech geek. I have an iPhone, I have a BlackBerry, so it's really up to me to keep our office on top of all the trends, whether it be reading Mashable like it was the Sunday New York Times, or making sure that I plow through my RSS reader to see if I can pull out any relevant information as it relates to the digital space and how we can sort of translate that into some of our client programs.
And tell us your thoughts on the coolest digital project you've worked on this year.
We did a fantastic sort of grassroots, old school, new school program with the a gentleman that is of a civil action fame, Jan Schlickman, the gentleman that was a lawyer on that famous case. He and some citizens in the state sued the Turnpike on behalf of the citizens of Massachusetts, that basically said half of the money that was taken from the Turnpike was incorrectly routed to the Big Dig and all the sort of the foul-ups they had at the Big Dig. So what we did was use a fairly strategic media relations program with a social media overlay that helped us activate Bostonians through the use of Facebook and Twitter to get them to go to the Massachusetts Toll Equity website to sign up for the petition. And over a three-month period, we nearly got about 3,000 visitors to the site and signed up.
And what's your prediction for the future of digital activity in MSNL?
I mean, in a previous video that my colleagues Dave Greeno and Mayor Murphy did, they talked about how there are going to be sort of a slew of new services in 2010, and I think that still plays out, but my main concern is sort of the consolidation of the space as it relates to content. I think, yes, there'll be a multitude of services coming out, whether it be things like Foursquare or how Twitter may evolve in 2010, but consumers are going to get smarter in terms of how to use these tools and be a little more selective in terms of how we use them and what sort of content we create for them. So we as consumers will be more selective as time goes on.
What's the one social media tool that you can't live without?
It's probably my mobile devices, whether it be my iPhone, my BlackBerry, or my wireless card, because I need to be connected, need to be able to, on a moment's notice, see what's trending on Twitter or see what the latest updates are in my RSS reader so I can sort of keep on top of the trends and keep my team up to date.